Talked about snipers. Now we have to talk about infantry scouts. This video is brought to you by the Midwest 34th Infantry Division. Here's the deal, ladies and gentlemen. There's a misconception that snipers are all special forces. They definitely can be special forces. But more often than not, they are 11 Bravos from the Scout Sniper Platoon that then went and graduated from sniper school. So what is the Scout Sniper Platoon then? Scout Sniper Platoon is a battalion-level asset for the infantry. A battalion is about 1,000 troops, which can then be divided into 5 or 6 companies. A company is about 200 troops that can then be divided into 3 to 4 platoons. And a platoon is anywhere from 20 to 50 guys. So out of 1,000 infantry grunts, you have 20 to 50 Scout Snipers. A Scout Sniper Platoon is typically something you have to go through a selection process to be a part of. Selection process is like a military tryout. So in theory, you should be an above-average grunt if you're part of the Scout Sniper Platoon. The Scout Sniper Platoon basically does two things. They escort Bill Nye the Science Grunt to his objective, and they conduct on-foot reconnaissance, which basically means they sneak around in the woods unnoticed, tell the regular infantry where the bad guys are, and then watch from afar as the infantry turns the bad guy into a giant flower bed. So I'm trying to tell you that infantry scouts are just grunts. They're a special kind of grunt. What makes them special is how fucking stealthy they are. It's like Invisigrunt. These guys can run full speed through the woods at night, wearing an 85-pound backpack and not make a single sound, leaving no evidence that they were ever there except for the faint smell of grizzly long-cut wintergreen and peppered beef jerky. The infantry scouts that I trained with would actually make their own George W. costumes out of real-life plants from the surrounding environment because they wanted to blend in as much as possible. These guys would actually paint their faces like the movies. They were so detailed and meticulous that they all wore their watches backwards because they didn't want the moonlight or the sunlight to catch the face of the watch and create a glare that could be seen from a distance. But if you were to ever ask them why they wore their watch backwards, that's not the answer you'd get. They would say something along the lines of, "So I know the enemy's time of death." Because if you're wearing your watch backwards on your non-dominant hand, you can actually see what time it is while you're shouldering your rifle. I'm trying to tell you these guys are the John Cena of the battlefield. Here's the deal, scouts are probably the only grunts that don't want to actually engage the enemy. They just want to go unnoticed and then go home. But one thing is certain, someone is going unnoticed. And if you accidentally find the scouts, making it so they can't go unnoticed, you're going to go unnoticed forever. But you're not only gonna die, you're gonna die silently. It's gonna be like a Charlie Chaplin film. I taught you guys about the Gurkhas and their slippery boomerangs. Allow me to introduce you to the American equivalent, the motherfucking E-tool. It is a collapsible shovel with a serrated edge that Uncle Sam issues to the troops so they can clear vegetation. Finding the scouts is probably the fastest way I can think of to come face to face with one of these. I'm trying to tell you they're gonna give you a throwback ass whooping. They're gonna stack your ass in 420p. You're gonna get unalived and analog. You're gonna get a one-way ticket to the Forever Box, so low-tech even Amish people think it's old school. In conclusion, if you're a bad guy and you ever see the infantry scouts, you should pretend you didn't, because it's gonna go from a game of hide-and-go-seek to shovel tag real quick. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoy my content and maybe like to buy me a beer about it, there's a link for that right here. That is also the link where you can find all my shirts and stickers, as well as my 1776 prescription sunglasses and my tactical underwear. So until next time, thank you for your service. Quack Bang out.